Welcome, Little Tech fam. So today we'll be speaking about the top 6 modifications you should do to your Volkswagen Mark 1 to slam it down all the way. So this will be the static way to slam down your Mark 1. So let's get started with number 1. So the number 1 modification you should do to your suspension is to buy you a set of coilovers. Buying a set of coilovers will be the easiest way. It's not the only way, but it will be the easiest way to slam down your car. Note, when setting these coilovers, or basically setting these coilovers in your car, you need to remove your helper spring and your bump stop. This will give you a more comfortable drive and it will basically give your car some more lows. Note that this is actually also very safe compared to cutting your springs and putting in lowering kits. Lowering kits and cut springs do lower your car, but to get the max lows out of your car and to get your car slammed down all the way on the floor and just to get it scraping, coilovers will be your best solution at the moment. The second thing I recommend is buying a set of hooves. I'll say buy a set of 15s. Buying a set of 15s will allow you to choose from a variety of rims, a variety of brand rims, and that will allow you to get the max lows on your car. The reason why I'm telling you this is because the third thing you can do to your car is buy yourself a set of stretch tires. I recommend the 165 50 15s. That won't give you the best of lows, but it will give you the lows you need to slam your car down. It will give your car that scraping low where you max out your car, your car will be scraping on the ground. And you will still be comfortable to drive daily. And trust me, the 45s are still right to drive daily, and the 165 40 15s, well, that's a bit out of my league. That's driving too low, and the best thing about the 165 50 15 is that from your tire to your arch, you will still have that great fitment. So just note, when going stance, you will be needing that fitment and that lows. My first step, the fourth modification I would say due to your ride, you will need to shim at your car. Because you have that stretch tire, you have that coilovers, you have that lows, you won't be necessarily be getting that fitment and that lows you will be needing. Because your shaft will be rubbing against the body of your car, basically of the chassis of the car. So now you will need to shim notch above your shaft of your car in order for your shaft to sit a little bit deeper onto your body or in your chassis so that your car will be going or need to go lower. This allows you to get that max lows you can on your coilovers at the moment, because if you lower your coilovers at the moment, you won't necessarily touch the rim, but your coilover will be maxed out and your car will be as low as possible, or that will be the lowest your car can go at the moment. So this is the reason why I'll say do the fifth modification to your ride, and that will be extended mountings or extended flip mount spaces. This modification is one of probably my best modification that you can do to your Mark 1, because this way your car drives softer, your coilovers are turned up higher, your coilovers lifespan increases. Doesn't like increases, but it like lasts longer compared to driving with the coilover very very low. So your coilovers lifespan is actually really really longer, and like I said, you drive really smoother on some more lows. So your car, it won't necessarily feel like you're driving very low, but to other people, your car will be sitting very nice and neatly low on the road.
Wow! The land of make-believe!
If you would like to buy your flip mount spaces or your extended mountings, you can contact me directly on my Instagram, which I'll put down below. You can contact me on Instagram and I'll send you guys the contact details of the people you need to contact to get yourself extended spaces or extended flip mounts. So now you have that lows, you have everything you need to slam down your car to the max. But now you're at the limbo, people are getting the same height on the roof as you, your sump is not touching the ground. But now you're getting this tip from me, and this will be not a modification, but the sixth step to slam down your ride. It's just to grind off the bottom part of your chassis, which is beneath the low control arms, just grind off like a few millimeters that you will be needing just to get that extra lows to beat the rest of the Mark 1s. I don't necessarily recommend this because I didn't do this to my own car, but a few people did. So, I don't usually recommend this, but you can, this is just a tip you guys can do afterwards. Or you can just take that punch each time in the road, and the guy behind you can just see that sparks flying each time you hit the pothole. So note, that's the road me and Jody, or a few of the guys I know it. We grinded our low control arms, or the bottom part of the chassis of the low control arms, by simply driving it, like it's scraping the whole time. So you can either grind it away or you can drive it away. So which I would recommend rather drive it away.
Okay.
So from this point on, your car's maxed out, you have the lows you need, you will be hitting that mid 120s on your roof by the limbo and whatsoever. So note, there are many other ways to slam down your car, but these are the steps I took to slam down my car. Note, you can always do a thinner profile tire, which will mean you will be going lower, but that will mean you will have a comfortable daily driven car. A lot of people are against this, but just note, this is just my opinion. So guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and find this video very helpful. Please do like this video and please do subscribe to my channel. Please do share this video out there, because this video will be posted, or the link of the video will be posted on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter. Mentioning my Twitter, I do have a Twitter account now. Please go follow me on Twitter. I'll put the name of my Twitter in the video just down here. So please do follow me on Twitter, because I'll be posting more on Twitter, I'll be more on Instagram, more on Facebook. I try to make a lot of content for you guys that will be helpful for you guys in the future. I met a lot of you guys in public, and I'm grateful for each and one of you's great feedback. I know I do make mistakes. I'm glad if you guys rectify me in the comments below. Just don't insult me. Just don't insult me. So, because I'm not insulting you, and this way we can reach agreement, I can give the proper feedback the next video or whatsoever. So like I said, I hope you guys find this video very, very helpful, because a lot of you guys ask me, where can I buy coilovers, where can I buy this, where can I buy that. I'll put everything in the description below, and if you guys do have a question, you guys can always contact me on Instagram. Please do prevent sending me WhatsApp messages, because I'm very busy on WhatsApp and I don't always have time to reply on WhatsApp, because I do have a social life of my own. So rather send me a message either on Facebook, or the best, which I would say, on Instagram. Before I leave you guys, please don't forget, hit that subscribe button and click that little bell to get notified whenever I'm uploading new content. So remember guys, peace out.